Michael, I remember when I did the review for Lincoln, I said that was the best superhero movie of the year. And I think that this movie also reminds us that you don't need a cape to be a hero. How do you approach a figure like Cesar Chavez?
It was a little bit different because he wasn't like a larger-than-life character. You know, he was very humble and actually a little bit of a loner. Mm-hmm. So with this guy, I really had to focus on a couple of things. And I'm like, number one, what was he trying to get accomplished? And how did he feel about it? And also, what was he like when he wasn't talking? And it was like, he would always like sit around and do that. And mm-hmm. there's no, you know, if it was like a very Hollywood movie, he would be, you know, always a most charismatic guy and doing this and that, you know. It just, you know, he just wasn't that guy, you know. He was like, it's almost like a very specific Latin thing of being very humble, mm-hmm. you know. Like, my dad is like that, where he's like, he doesn't want the limelight, but he, you know, he did something great. He came out to America and worked two jobs just to put us through school and just, you know, just led by example. And I think that's what this guy did. And also the way he spoke, mm-hmm. You know, because, you know, it's just like the old school movies, like, well, you have to understand, right? You know, like, he actually spoke like that. And I was like, there was no way to get around it. You know, mm-hmm. I had to learn how to do that and try to be as real as possible with that. And also I had to gain 30 pounds and, you know, shave a little stuff. But it was a tough role because you, like, as an actor, you want to do it. Mm-hmm. And this one held it back a little bit, you know. Diego's always pretty adamant about, like, keeping it, you know, mm-hmm. very, very, very low key.
You have a couple of very powerful speeches. What went through your mind during those moments? Because I was wondering, are you thinking about what happened then? Are you thinking about what's going on still today with Latinos in society? How was that?
I just treat it like if it's happening right now. You know, it's still kind of happening right now. You know, in big business, you know, like, I know, like, my brother got laid off from a bank, you know, because he felt the ripple effect of, you know, all the stuff that was going on with the, you know, when people were getting bailouts or whatever, and the executives were giving themselves bonuses, even mm-hmm. though they for sure didn't deserve it. You know, like, in a sinking ship, who's gonna give you more money, more gold? You're like, you're sinking, man. So that stuff still happens. So it's almost like a resentment, a disgust that you have when somebody's cheating somebody out of something. Mm-hmm. And it's very real. And it's something that, you know, it kind of seems to be like an ongoing subject.
Awesome, thank you so much. Yeah.